Right, so tonight I'm going to fold. Well, my arms look really skinny, but they're not. That's just the light. That's funny. I was going to really focus this evening on plants, because I'm really into this gardening lately. I'm like their mother, you know. I've created them, I brought them in, and I'm their nurturer. And so today I was out there and I'm just looking, because I built like this little tiny fence out of sticks, you know, so it looks more like, what do you call that, idyllic, with the old England and all of that. So I made this little fence to block the sunlight, because the sunlight here is so harsh that the turnips behind this fence, they just wilt in the midday. So I built, because I didn't want to put umbrellas up, because here in this area of the world they use umbrellas, and the wind happens, and then when the wind happens the umbrellas will go all over and hurt the plants even more. So I don't want to use umbrellas. But anyway, so today I'm out there, and there's one plant, one turnip leaf, just snuck out there and put his little chin out on the fence. And then I'm like, well, what's the deal? He just went out there, put his chin on the fence, and then it's in the sunshine, bright sunshine. And I'm like, in my own head, I'm going, what are you doing? And then I'm like, not thinking about myself talking at all, I'm actually hearing more the plants surrounding him. And it's just like they were saying, what are you doing? Like, that is dangerous, don't go there. And it was almost like, you know, that I hate to say it, that a Jewish melange where it's just like, don't do it, you know, it's too dangerous, you know, you don't you know we've heard about the sunshine, it's bad for you. So all of this was going on, and this is like, this he was just being a real, like, I'm just going to go out there and get into the sunshine, whether they like it or not, you know. So he was being like a bad, in a way, and making all the others worried behind him, because they're like, no, we don't want to. So there was really like this weird repartee going on with the plants right there. And they were of the same ilk. They were all the same origin there. And even their own leaves participating in this discussion. So it was very, very fun. It was a very, very fun day. Because I've been reading a lot about the and hearing a lot. Yeah, we know they hear. We know plants hear. This has now been discovered by science. They hear. So if you talk, they can hear you. If you yell, they can hear you. If you sing, they can hear you. Now, when I'm going on through all of this, yes, back in France, there's a man who blasts out classical music to his vineyard, and yes, it's doing very well, and all of this, his vineyard grows a third more than normal. So it really is something that is just like an enriching experience for the plants. Just they get excited, they get happy. You know, to hear classical music all day long, though, I'm sitting here thinking in my head, you know, through the megaphones, that's okay, but all day, you know, maybe is that like an odd development? I mean, should there be some, like, you know, adaptability to other types of music? It doesn't, in a way, it almost seems like, is that fair to the plants? You know, maybe they need to hear other types of music. Maybe they need to hear reggae. Maybe they need to hear a little soft rock or something. Something calm, but something that is a little bit different. You know, maybe they want to, you know, something else sometimes. That was just my little observation of it. Because I believe, like today, as I discovered with this one, that is just like the boisterous. I'm out there in the sunshine, and on the other side of the fence, peeking through, ha ha. I'm doing that in spite of everything, in spite of the fence that she built, in spite of the friends behind me that said no, I'm doing this in, you know, just to be different. So in a way, are those huge fields and meadows that are getting the megaphone of classical music, are they really getting satisfied, or is it going to be a generalization of satisfaction rather than each individual doesn't actually have his or her true independence in musical selection? Do you understand what I'm saying? So if those plants could decide on an individual basis, I want to hear this type, I would prefer it, you know, that would be a neat upgrade, you know, rather than, yes, we know it's classical and it's growth and it makes us all just happy and content and calm and sophisticated and social, so all of this is happening, and yet in the same tone there's the one that is that wants to have his independence and is sneaky out on the side and says, I'm blasting myself in the sunshine, even though I can burn or scorch my leaves, even though I may wilt, I'm still gonna do it. You know, for some reason that plant, it made that decision that it wanted to burn, possibly. You know, don't touch the fire, like the child, don't touch the fire. But they do it anyway, they want to test. They don't want to believe the others. You know, he didn't want to believe the others. And so, in an odd way, it's like, where does intelligence begin? Where does consciousness state and relegation of satisfaction and choices and options, where does all of this begin? I mean, the plants themselves are so dedicated to their own choices, so dedicated to their own satisfactions. I really, really, really don't think it started with us. They're making and deciding and making and deciding and making and deciding every day. But conversations, these communications going on, like really, how sophisticated are they? And how dumb-numb are we in just to be walking plants? Whereas the ones there with static roots, they have the same and similar conversations. So, I don't know. I just don't want to pride myself out as being human, that my conversations are anything higher in relegation than that of a typical plant. I don't think they're any different. I think a typical plant, any kind, has all kinds of things going on to say. I think he has all kinds of independence, all kinds of choices, all kinds of opinions. So, there we are. Someday it will be proven. We'll get it through. Get it through the grapevine. You know, science will prove it. You know, and we'll be like, oh, what a bunch of dum-dums are we? I don't really want to walk on that one. You know, he's talking. I don't want to. Anyway, that's all. It's a simple video.